Welcome to A Taste of Acton. We're here in Acton TV's television studio in the kitchen set, and I'm here with Joe and John LeBlundo of Twin Seafood. And guys, you got a real treat for us today. What are we making?
All right, we're gonna go with a little seafood today. We're gonna start with a Maryland crab cake. Fantastic. It's gonna be delicious. We're gonna saute it in a little bit of olive oil. It's gonna be made very simple so you can really taste the crab. Then we're gonna make a Caesar salad with our homemade, from our mother's recipe, Caesar salad dressing.
Mama knows best.
And then we're gonna go with the baked stuffed lobster, which is kind of our signature dish at Twin Seafood. We're gonna bake stuff this with a little bit of the New Bedford sea scallops and the Gulf shrimp.
Fantastic.
Yeah, and I'm gonna throw this bad boy right in the pot right now. I'm
going
to talk a little bit about, before we go to break and get going with the crab cakes, I'm going to talk a little bit about the difference between the lobsters, a male and a female. If we can get a good shot on it, this lobster right here is a male. It has a thinner tail, and it has where these, the small feet right here are hard from when they populate the eggs of the female.
Okay.
And then this lobster right here is a female. It has the softer upper legs, which identifies the female, also with a wider tail
base,
which is similar to, you know, a lot of females.
So, now, all right. I love lobster, but I know very little about them. And so you guys were telling me that there's two kinds of lobster.
Yeah, well, there's multiple kinds of lobsters.
Okay.
You have albino lobsters,
yeah.
But there's one in, what, 100 million is an albino lobster, and an albino lobster is a white lobster.
Are those more expensive at the store?
Honestly, I've never seen an albino lobster.
Okay.
And then there's the blue lobster, which is what?
It's one in about 1 million.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is literally the color of the shell. As what you saw we put in there, this lobster here was more brown.
Right.
It's very, very, very blue.
Right.
And it's actually a beautiful thing. They had one at the aquarium in Boston for a while, and it's very rare.
Yeah.
You know, you really don't want to stick a blue lobster in a pot of boiling water because they are fairly rare.
And you know what's funny about lobsters also is that it takes 7 years for a lobster to grow to be 1 pound.
No kidding.
And then every pound after that is about 3 years.
Yeah.
So if you're looking at some of these bigger lobsters that they show, like a 30-pound lobster,
right.
That thing's somewhere around, it's over 90 years old.
Wow.
So, I mean, it's kind of a cool thing. But we're gonna come back, we're gonna go, and we're gonna do the Maryland crab cakes right after this break.
Body language can tell you all sorts of things. Like someone is having a stroke. Know the sudden signs. Learn fast. Face drooping, arm weakness, speech difficulty. Time to call 911 and get them to a hospital immediately. Learn the body language and spot a stroke fast.
Hello, welcome back to A Taste of Acton. On today's show, as you already know, we have Twin Seafood, and the guys, they just threw some delicious lobsters in the pot.
Yep.
And you're going to show us how you can tell when a lobster is done. I thought it was when they stopped screaming.
They stopped screaming. You know, the funny thing, Rick, right? Honestly, when you throw them in, they don't even know what's going on. They think they're going into a jacuzzi, nice, warm, beautiful.
Do you whisper in their ear before you dump them in?
But you know what? Honestly, that's a total fallacy about them screaming. They don't scream. They don't know what's going on. They think that you're cooking corn.
Okay.
You know, so it's not a big deal. But
what that sound is, though,
yeah,
is it's the air releasing from the shell.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So some people will hear a high pitched noise.
Yeah.
And that's just the air coming out of the shell.
Basically, well, that makes me feel a little better.
Basically, it's when they're dying, man. That's what it is.
So, like a quick way to tell if your lobster is done, other than using some of the guidelines that are on Google. You can go on Google and say, hey, how do I cook a 2-pound lobster? How do I cook a pound and a half lobster? But a good way, after it's been cooking for a while, you take the antenna and you just tug it like that.
Oh, look at that.
It comes off easy like that, that thing's done. So
Fantastic.
That bad boy's done. Let's pull it out of there and get it with our other guys.
Yeah, let me grab that tray for you.
Yeah, there we go. There's our lobsters that we're going to be big stuffing. It's going to be a beautiful thing.
And so, then, yeah. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
So anyways, just to get back to the lobsters just a little bit, there's a difference between, we use all lobsters from Western Nova Scotia. And the reason that we do that is because typically we're able to get hard shell lobsters all year round. And the difference between a hard shell and a soft shell lobster is the amount of meat that's inside of them. So when a lobster turns soft, what it's doing is it's molting. And when it molts, the meat actually pulls away from the shell and it fills with water. So when the meat pulls away from the shell and fills with water, obviously the amount of meat that's in that lobster, maybe a pound and a half lobster, just like a hard shell lobster is a pound and a half, but you're gonna get maybe about 25% less,
yeah,
John?
Or more. I mean, yeah, you don't get the meat.
Yeah, you're gonna get probably 25% less meat out of a hard shell, out of a soft shell lobster than you would out of a hard shell lobster.
So, fascinating, I never knew that.
Yeah, so that's why most lobsters are all hard in the wintertime, right? But up in Western Nova Scotia, where the water is, you know, very cold, we're able to get hard shell lobsters all year round. So, you know, we just think that it's such a better quality lobster. That's why we insist on using hard shell lobsters all the time.
We only sell hard shells.
Fantastic. I mean,
because we've been through the experience of sending out some soft shell lobsters, or what they call firms, which is kind of a lobster that's in between a hard shell and a soft shell. It's a firm, so it's already shedded its shell and the shell's starting to firm up. But still, there's not the meat. So we've had some complaints about that. So all we sell is hard shells, and we never have a complaint with the lobsters that we sell out. Yeah,
I can see why.
Yeah,
so now, beautiful. Over here on the end, you guys are getting ready to make some crab cakes?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so what we're going to do here is we're going to make some Maryland crab cakes for an appetizer to our dinner tonight. We use a nice lump back fin crab meat from Maryland. This is from the Blue Crabs, which some people, I'm sure, recognize them as a soft shell crab. This is when they're hard. So again, getting back to where the lobsters were, when a crab molts, it's a soft shell crab. And those there, you know, those are typically available around May. But this here is from the hard shell, same thing. They're called Jimmies. And they're from Maryland. And this is from the back fin. So this makes a really nice crab meat. I mean, a crab cake, because it's lump. You know, it's lump crab meat.
Now, did you say the back fin?
Yes.
So crabs have a fin, or is that just the whole shell?
Yeah, it's kind of a fin.
It's kind of a fin. It's more what it's really called is the apron.
Yeah.
Okay. Which is on the back of a crab, and you pull that back, and the meat is literally right in that area, right where the apron.
Right in
is.
The rump.
Yeah. Right in the butt.
I gotcha.
But it makes a nice crab cake because it stays together. Along with the crab meat, we're gonna add crushed Ritz crackers. And we use Ritz crackers rather than breadcrumbs because it already has the salt, has a lot of butter content in there. It's just a nicer flavor.
Much better.
You know, we use a little bit of mayonnaise and egg. And both the mayonnaise and the egg we use them as a binder.
Okay.
Keeps them together, right? So they don't just fall apart. And then what we like to do is we like to coat them in panko. So panko is a Japanese breadcrumb, which stays nice and crisp, you know? So that's basically what we're gonna do here. And of course, in the Maryland tradition, we're gonna use Old Bay seasoning.
Okay, fantastic. Okay?
So Old Bay seasoning is what they do crab boils with. They cover the crabs in Old Bay seasoning and steam them. It's delicious. It's one of my favorite spices to use in seafood of all time.
Yeah, great. It's not too spicy. It's got a lot of flavor, and it really gives the crab cake a nice kick.
Awesome.
You know, and we're also going to make a simple romelade, which is mayonnaise, relish, a little bit of dry onion, and some cocktail sauce.
And is that for after
that's
the like fact?
A, no, that's a sauce that you'll use with the crab.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah,
gotcha.
It's easy to mix up. People can do it very, very simple, okay. And it's great.
Fantastic.
And if you wanted to make it a little bit more spicy, you could add a little bit of Louisiana hot sauce, and it makes it awesome.
Great.
So,
So while you guys are doing that, I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about your background. How did you guys get started with seafood and restaurants, but seafood in particular?
Well, I'll tell you, when we were growing up, we grew up in Somerville.
Okay.
And a buddy of ours, Marty Haggerty, his dad owned Fresh Pond Seafood right in Cambridge. It was right at the circle there. I don't know if you know Cambridge at all.
But I'll take your word for it.
Yeah. So we used to work there. You know, you'd work there after school. You worked there on the holidays. You worked there, you know, the big holidays like the day before Thanksgiving, the day before Christmas, New Year's Eve. And those are the big times. But we kind of figured out what was going on in the fish business. Plus, we looked at him and we said, now this guy owns a small fish store. He's got a house in Lexington. He's got a house down the Vineyard. And he's got a house down in Florida.
Now, how old were you guys when you figured this out, the secret of life?
Well, like 16, 17 years?
I worked there full-time.
Yeah.
From, I remember the first week that I worked there was 1978, when the Red Sox lost to the Yankees in that one single playoff game. And Bucky Dent.
Oh, Bucky Dent.
Bucky Dent hit the home run
Bucky expletive Dent.
Exactly. So he hit the home run to put it away, right? So that's when I started. And, you know, a story that I like to tell people is that, you know, this is really all I've ever done, right? So I've never even been on a job interview in my entire life.
No kidding. Right?
So I worked there for 12 years. And then I went to work for a small gourmet food store. And then John and I, that's when we decided to open something ourselves. And John is actually an electrical engineer.
Yeah.
And
you all.
Yeah. So we opened the store. We found a nice spot in Concord, and we opened the store in Concord. And you know, we've been in Concord now. This coming June will be 22 years. So
Concord, would you consider that your main store? Is the bigger of the two?
Yeah, it's definitely the main store. I mean, it was the first one. But you know, the one other thing, you know, so we learned like the whole fish business down at Fresh Pond Seafood.
Right.
Okay, and Joe kind of ran with it. He did it for years. Okay, and I was always there, you know, helping out whenever. But then we also used to cook down at the feast down the North End.
Oh, okay.
We used to do the Fisherman's Feast. We used to do the St. Anthony's Feast. And that's where we learned kind of the whole frying game. You know, okay, so how to cook the fried clams, how to cook the fish and chips and stuff like that. And we did that for, 10 or 12 years, Joe?
We did that, yeah, we did that from 1982.
Yeah.
And the final year that we did it was...
The tall ship, right?
Yeah, 1996.
Yeah.
So we did it for a number of years, and it was, you know, it was a nice thing. It was a lot of fun. It was, you know, it was in the North End.
Oh, it was awesome.
I mean, how much better can it get
to
be out in the street, cooking fish,
singing,
and just having a good time.
You guys sing too?
Oh, yeah, we sing. What are you talking about?
Well, we had a dance back then too. That was the Madison.
The Madison. You can do that.
Is it appropriate for television?
It's great. It's tremendous.
I don't know. I gotta take off my pants and stuff.
Yeah, the pants gotta come off. But other than that, it's totally appropriate.
Other than that, it's pretty good.
It's awesome. But yeah, so we were down there, and so we learned the whole like cooking end of it.
Yeah.
And so when we opened our shop, we opened it with both fresh fish and the cooking side. And not initially, but we gradually brought on the cooking side. And you know what, in the fish business, both of those go hand in hand. I think you really have to have it, because it's not like a liquor store where you throw your cases of Bud in the fridge, and you throw your bottles of whiskey on the shelf. And you know what, if it sells in a week, yeah, you're good. If it sells in a month, you're still good.
That's a good point.
No,
I didn't even think of
it. Fish is three days, man.
Yeah.
Buy it, cut it, sell it.
Yeah.
You know, that's what you got to do. And you know, the places that run into trouble are the places that don't move it.
Right.
You know, if you're moving a lot of fish, it's going to be beautiful.
Yeah.
And if you're not moving a lot of fish, it's not going to be beautiful.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a tricky business, but you know, we've been doing it a long time, so I think we kind of have it down to...
It seems to be working out okay for you guys.
Yeah, we know what to buy, how much to buy, and how to cook it. So that's the key.
Absolutely.
So what are we doing?
Real quickly, let's get back to the crab cakes real quick, right? So it's about a pound of Maryland crab meat that I showed you earlier. A couple of good helpings of mayonnaise, a good heavy mayonnaise, right, for the flavor. I use two eggs as a binder. I'm going to add some Old Bay seasoning. right now, and this is completely for flavor. And you can do this to taste. So whatever you like. I mean, I like it a little bit heavy with the Old Bay, you know, because it, again, like I say, it's one of my favorite spices with fish. And we're going to throw a little bit of diced yellow sweet pepper in there as well.
All right. I would say on the pepper. So we have a pound of crab meat. I would go with like a half of a small pepper. You know, this is a pretty big pepper. I'm using about a quarter of it. So I, you know, that's about it. I wouldn't overkill it. You know, just a nice little bit, you know, add a little flavor and I'll add a little texture, but that's about it. I wouldn't do any more than that. What do you think?
Yeah, that's plenty. No, it's plenty.
Okay.
We just get a nice mix. We just get a nice mix in here.
Okay.
Right? And you can see that, you know, the egg keeps it together, nice binder. Right?
They're getting a shot. Oh, they're getting the overhead shot on it.
There it is.
Right?
Wow, look at how beautiful
I got to keep my head back so they don't see the balls fall.
I got mine. All right. Back.
Yeah. All right, so, and then all you need to do, it's like, you know, it's kind of like making a cookie or whatever. So you roll it like a nice meatball.
Yep.
Flatten it down a little bit.
Bingo, in the pan.
Okay? And then we're gonna hit it with a little bit of panko, the Japanese breadcrumb that I said.
Panko.
All right?
A little
nice, just like that. Make sure it's coated nicely on both sides. Press it in a little bit.
I'm looking for a spatula.
And we got some nice hot olive oil here.
Beautiful, thank you.
And we're gonna just fry them.
Oh yeah. Now you know what's interesting about this mix?
What's
right?
that?
Okay, so you have about a pound of crab meat, probably, you know, maybe a cup of Ritz crackers.
Yep.
Maybe like a quarter cup of pepper, but I mean, you could make anywhere from like four nice crab cakes or to eight, you know, reasonably sized crab cakes. So if you wanted to do, you know, something like this, if you wanted to do an appetizer for eight people, yeah. You know, you make your eight crab cakes, you do a little romelade, you put it out there, and that gets you started. It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
And it's easy.
Yeah.
You know? It's easy. I mean,
well, it's easy for you guys.
No, it's easy. Yeah. I mean, what do we do?
Well, don't tell them it's too easy. Well, you still want them to come down.
No, they say, you know, they can buy the crab. You know, we can make it for. It's not a big deal.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's delicious.
So it makes a lot out of the mix.
Yeah. You get a lot out of that mix, and people will be saying, wow,
yeah,
how did you make that?
And
I
you
mean,
know,
what do we add? Like four ingredients to it? Come on now.
And the crab meat's all cooked, right? So really what you want to do is you want to get a nice brown on those. John, flip those.
Yep, I'm on it. Oh, yeah.
Right, so you want to get a nice golden brown just like that.
That's
right?
Beautiful.
Beautiful thing. Get a golden brown.
So you get a nice golden brown on both sides, and then if you're when these are done, if your company hasn't come yet or whatever, you know, you could take them off a little bit early and you put them in the oven at a nice warming temperature, maybe 275, something like that, and they can sit for a bit, you know. So you really don't have to be in the kitchen when your company comes.
Right.
So you can do this in advance.
Yeah.
You know, and pop them in the oven, and it's, you know, it's beautiful.
Absolutely. And if you don't want to do it, we can do it.
There you go.
So, okay, we're going to make the romelade. You got this on the overhead cam? All right, so you're going to use basically 2 cups of mayo.
Okay.
Right? A cup of cocktail sauce, Twin Seafood cocktail sauce. Very good.
Special mix.
Yeah. Maybe not the whole thing. Maybe just a little under a cup. Okay. And then we're going to use, this is dill relish. The dill relish is key. You don't want to use the sweet relish. You want to use the dill relish. And you mix that baby right in there, okay? So you take that, you mix it up, nice. And if you want to, like I said earlier, if you want to add a little bit of Louisiana hot sauce.
A little kick?
Yeah, get to give it a little kick, that'd be nice. And you can also add, sometimes we add a little bit of onion to this, dry onion. But this right here will work. It's nice. It's easy. You mix it up, and then you just put it right on your crab cakes on the side as you're serving it, and people can use it as they want. And that's it. I mean, how long did it take to cook that? Come on now.
It's pretty quick.
How long did it take to put it together? It's nothing. And you can get all the ingredients at Twin, so that's not a big deal. And if you want a little Old Bay because we like it, there you go.
It's the do it all, huh?
Yeah.
It is, really.
It's on
it really is.
Yeah. pop it right in there. All right.
So we're going to let those fry up.
Yep.
And we'll be back right after this.
All right.
At shelters, you'll discover healthy and loving animals just waiting to become a part of your family. Why wait? You can make a difference in the life of an animal. A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person and adopt your new best friend today. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
All right, welcome back to Taste of Acton. We're here with Twin Seafood and Joe and John LeBlondo. Crab cakes are all done and
beautiful.
Fantastic. It smells awesome in here.
They're going to be great, and you guys are going to get to eat them.
I know. I can't wait. That's the best part of the show.
We're going to pop these in. We got, how many did we get? We got 11 crab cakes out of a pound of crab meat. That's beautiful. So they're going to go in the oven. They're going to stay warm. They're going to cook from the inside out, and we're going to have those out
on the bottom.
Nice. And we'll have those out, and we'll be ready to eat them.
So how long do you think they're good in the oven? How long will they stay?
They're not going to be in there that long. Maybe
I mean, like you said, if you were making them for a party, I mean, how long can you eat them before you get 10 minutes?
10 minutes at 350, just to warm them from the inside.
All right.
And then they're ready to rock and roll.
And what do we got going on over here now?
Go ahead, Joey.
All right, so we're gonna make a Caesar salad, you know, because, you know, you got to have some roughage in your diet too, right? You just can't eat butter and mayonnaise and cheese and all that stuff, even though that's basically how I live
try.
My life. You know, but we got some chopped romaine here, so we're gonna make a real simple Caesar salad dressing, okay? You know, you can get into Caesar salad dressings, you can get into the raw eggs and the anchovies and all that stuff there. But this here is a real simple, something that you can make at home really, really easily, okay? You use a very heavy, heavy mayonnaise, about 2 cups.
Nice.
Depending on how much salad you're making, but I'm gonna make all of this.
Beautiful.
So we use that. And then we're gonna do some lemon juice, right? So, you know, try to get a nice thin skin lemon.
Okay, how can you tell that the lemon's thin skin?
Well, if you can press on it, right?
Okay,
because the thick skin lemons, there's no juice in them. You know, it's kind of lousy.
Plus, if you insult a thin skin lemon, they
does
get
it
upset.
Bruise?
They get upset. They definitely do. So you wanna roll it.
Nice.
Roll it on the counter, which will make it soft.
Okay.
Yeah, right? Beautiful.
And what are you doing? You're trying to get the pulp away from the skin?
I'm just trying to get the pulp away from the skin and to open and to loosen up the juice a little bit, you know, and get a strainer, real simple strainer. You need the juice from about 3 lemons.
Nice.
With 2 cups of mayonnaise.
Let me help you.
If you can just roll those out, John, that'd be awesome.
I can do that.
Nice and easy.
Plus, it's a good workout. You can tell. Can anybody see?
Can you see those pecs?
Anybody see the bicep working there? No. You don't want to show that, Shane?
So, when we were in the break, we were talking, and I didn't even realize it, but you guys do catering as well.
Absolutely.
So if you got a party going on, you don't want to make the seafood, you guys call. And is it that like a full menu type thing?
We do anything from prime rib to tenderloin to pork
tenderloin.
Oh,
so you guys aren't even limited.
We do full clam bakes. We do steaks. You can do sirloin steak. You can do ribeyes. Anything. We send a whole staff out. We bring everything you need, the plates, the tables. We serve in a buffet type style.
Yeah.
And we do a ton of clam bakes. Actually, you can do a clam bake on the deck up in Acton.
Oh, no kidding.
Yep. And you can rent the deck up there, no problem. We have music. I have like 2 or 3 musicians that work on at the shop up there. We can supply the music.
So you can have a private party on the deck?
Private
rent
party.
Right out?
Acton has a carrying license. So you want to bring your beer, you want to bring your wine. We've already done 4 or 5 of them.
No kidding.
And they've always been a good time. I mean, I always have a good time. I don't know. But yeah, it's a good time. But full catering. Then we also,
we can do raw bars.
Yeah.
What's a raw bar?
So a raw bar is basically oysters on the half shell.
Okay.
Little necks on the half shell.
Yeah.
You can get cooked shrimp along with it. Or we can do the stone crabs from Florida.
Yeah, those are nice.
You know, which are the cocktail crabs, which are delicious.
Yep.
So there's a, you know, our catering is very well versed. We have a gentleman at the store in Concord. He's a master chef from Germany. He goes out and does a lot of these parties for us, and he does a really nice job. So he expanded our menu as far as catering goes.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, so now, I mean, we're pretty well versed in catering. We can handle all the way up to about 300 to 400 people.
No kidding. That's a big party.
We've done we did a catering for Baxter Medical over in Bedford,
was 200 people.
It was 250 people.
Yeah.
Doris Kern went very well.
Doris Kern Goodwin's son.
We did his wedding.
That had to be 250 people.
Yeah.
And now for the unread in our audience, you guys have to tell us who Doris is, because I had no clue.
Doris Kearns Goodwin, she wrote a couple of books. I don't know how many books she wrote, but she definitely wrote a nice book about the Red Sox.
Okay.
Because she's a huge Red Sox fan.
Yeah.
And she comes in the store in Concord. And then she wrote the book, the biology, about,
Lincoln.
A story.
Yeah.
Autobiography
about Lincoln. And that became the movie
yeah.
that's out now.
Fantastic.
Yeah. So yeah, so she's very accomplished, and we did her son's wedding, and it was right in her backyard, and it was like 250 people. We did steaks, we did lobsters, we did
steamers.
Yeah, awesome. Steamers, all
clam chowder.
It was great. She loved it, and it was a great time. I gotta say, like, all the catering that's done out of Acton is done by Rick Gordon, who used to have Savory Lane in Acton, which is right around the corner from where we are. He does a great job. Everybody loves him. So,
fantastic.
Ricky, I'm thinking of you.
So what else you got going on?
So real quickly, back to the dressing, right? So it's just the mayonnaise. I squeezed the juice from 3 lemons in there, and then a good, like, pecorino Romano cheese. Maybe a good cup of that. Depending on, you know, right the flavor. John, can you pass me the pepper?
Yep.
A little bit of ground pepper. Again, to taste. You definitely do not need salt because we overloaded it with cheese.
So, yep.
So that's all good. And then just a whisk. Whisk it. You want to get the right consistency, right? So, you know, just a nice dressing.
That if you think delicious.
If you think you need a little bit of more mayonnaise, if you want it a little thicker, you can do that. If you want it a little bit thinner, there's a number of things you can do. You can add a little bit of olive oil if you like, or you can add a little bit more lemon. But to me,
that's the true test right there.
I think that's perfect.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
You know? And so, that's a real simple Caesar dressing.
It's beautiful.
Everybody loses their mind about making Caesar dressing. This is easy.
Right. Yeah, it'll look pretty easy. Yeah, tell
Should
us
we
what's
go
going
for
on
okay,
here.
Okay, so we're going to do a simple crouton for the Caesar salad. This is an Iggy French bread.
Okay.
Very, very good. We sell it at the store in Concord. It's awesome. I don't take them home anymore.
You used to.
Because my son and I eat the whole thing with like a stick of butter. So, but it's delicious. It's great. You pop it in the oven. If you want to eat the whole thing, if you want to eat it just for like dinner, you just pop it in the oven, take it home from the store, pop it in the oven, 5 minutes, 375. It comes out like it's fresh baked. It's unbelievable.
Fantastic.
But here's the croutons, okay? I cut about half the bread.
I'll cut the rest up for you, John.
Okay, do you want to do them all? Do we need them all?
Yeah, we're going to need a little bit more.
All right, so you're going to put a little bit of salt, if I can get this thing to shake. There we go. And
we're going to
put a little bit of salt on there, right? Yep, nice. We'll do a little bit of pepper. Little ground pepper. That's going to be beautiful. All right. Yeah, see if you can get that fixed. Yeah, will you,
I'll work on that for
you. Okay.
That's our trick salt.
That's a trick salt. You sure it's not a candle?
Yeah, it might be. It might be. It's a little salt.
And then we're going to put a little bit of the Romano cheese on here. And then we're going to bake it 375 for about, and a little olive oil. And then we're going to bake it 375 for about 15 minutes just to brown them up. And that's going to be beautiful. Oh, look at that.
And it's just a nice homemade crouton.
Yeah, it looks
You know,
fantastic.
there's nothing complicated to it. But, you know, you buy the ones in the bag, and those are fine and everything like that. But this is made with nice fresh bread. It's baked.
Olive oil.
Yeah,
olive
and you know what I'm learning here is I can't get over how easy it is for all the stuff that you guys are making. I mean, it's stuff that I'm not a big cook, but I could do this. You know,
yeah.
It's fantastic. You guys just make it look so easy.
Fish dishes are easy. You don't want to overcook them. You undercook them if possible, and you know, 20 minutes, 25 minutes on fish, and then if you make a salad and some rice, or you know, you can have some bread and some salad with the fish. Yeah. It's easy. That looks beautiful.
Yep.
Looks
perfect.
Fantastic.
So you know, you don't want to overload it with olive oil like John just did. It's nice, just a nice little coating.
No, what do you mean? You're telling me it's overloaded?
No. I think it's perfect, honestly. Don't make me smash this tray over your head.
All right, that's
brotherly love right there.
It's gonna go in. What are you gonna put it on the 350 or 300?
We're gonna crank that up a little bit to 375, like John said.
And then we'll let those cook up, and now we'll go right on the salad, and we'll mix that up, and
fantastic.
You guys are gonna be living large.
Great. We're gonna take another break, and we will be right back after this. And we're gonna do what? We're gonna make the stuff for the stuff for the baked stuffed lobster.
Oh, yeah.
So stay right there. We'll be right back.
Yep. Should be good.
When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified, not knowing what to do. They do nothing. But the people who take action are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
Hey, welcome back to A Taste of Acton. We're here with Twin Seafood again in the Acton TV lovely kitchen. And guys, we've already got the good makings of a feast going on here. But what's next? What's the final step here?
We're going to make the stuffing for the baked stuffed lobsters.
Yep, the stuffing is going to consist of, we're going to start with a little bit of olive oil, pop it into the pan. Then we're going to chop up some garlic, just a little bit to cover the bottom of the pan.
So now I notice that we got scallops and shrimp here.
Yeah.
So it's not just stuffing, it's like a meat stuffing almost.
Oh yeah, it's going to be a scallop and shrimp stuffing.
Sounds fantastic.
Okay, it's beautiful. So we have 3/4 of a pound of scallops and 3/4 of a pound of shrimp.
Okay.
I'm gonna dice the scallops into quarters, and then, so that gives us like 12 ounces of each. So what you wanna do for, we have 4 lobsters, so you want 3 ounces of scallops and 3 ounces of shrimp per lobster.
Okay.
Okay, that's how we usually do our stuffing. Okay, and it's basically the scallops, the shrimp, a little bit of olive oil. We're gonna put a little bit of butter in there. I'm gonna chop up some garlic.
Okay.
And then we're gonna put a little parsley and a little bit of fish stock.
Fantastic.
And that's it. That's all we're gonna do. So I'm gonna start chopping the garlic, get that going. And you know what? You know what's funny, right? Is I always think, whenever I cut garlic, I always think of that scene in Goodfellas, right? You know, where Ray Liotta, he's in prison. They sent him away, right? And the boss is yelling at him. He's like, you gotta cut the garlic. And he's cutting the garlic with a razor, and he's cutting it real thin, and he's taking his time, right? Because he's in prison. He's
right.
Got all the time in the world, right? So he's cutting the garlic real thin, and then he puts it in there, and it caramelizes right in the oil. I always think about that. I'm not going to do that, but I always think about that.
Well, you know, funny enough, speaking of gangster movies,
prison, right?
Yeah, right.
And the mob and The Godfather.
Oh, yeah.
It reminds me that you guys were telling me about a meal that you guys came up with called the Codfather.
Yes.
So what is this monstrosity?
So what we're going to do is, you've seen on the,
I think it's on the Food Network.
Travel Network.
Oh, yeah. Maybe Travel.
I think it's on Travel Network.
With Adam.
It's man versus food.
Okay, so you got a large quantity of
right.
food.
Right, so this guy has to either eat, like, steaming hot wings that just a lot of habanero peppers and things like that, or he has to eat. I've seen him eat like a 6-pound burrito.
Okay.
Right. So what we're gonna do, and we're gonna do it in the store in Acton.
Okay.
And we already have someone to sit down and eat the meal for us.
Oh, fantastic.
A guy named Armin Young. He's a friend of ours.
Well, maybe you guys will invite us out for that.
He's a character and a half. The guy's beautiful.
Right. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a spoof on that, right?
Okay.
So we're going to do a man versus food.
Acton. And what it's going to be is we're going to do, I don't know, we haven't really come up with exactly the numbers of fish but...
We don't want to kill the poor guy.
Okay.
So we're going to come up with 4 pounds of fish. So we're going to
fry
4 pounds of fish, cod or haddock. Okay, we're going to do 1/2 pound of onion rings, 1/2 pound of french fries, and 1/2 pound of coleslaw.
Oh.
So it's going to be 5.5 pounds of
The first
of
15
food.
Minutes of that meal sounds fantastic.
But if you watch Man, Joe, if you watch Man versus Food, it's usually somewhere between like the 5 and 6 pound range, you know?
Yeah.
So
but you know, he's going to have to sit down and he's going to have to eat the whole thing.
Right.
Okay.
You know, and if he does it, we'll have some nice Cod Father shirts made up.
Okay.
And if he does it, he'll get a picture on the wall and he'll get a shirt that says the Cod Father.
Fantastic.
You know?
So and then is this going to be something that's available for anybody that just wants
yeah,
to walk
so,
in
yeah,
and
so,
give it a shot?
Yeah, yeah. So we'll have it available in the store.
So it'll be like the local Acton challenge, right?
Yeah, right. And if you do it, you know, you'll get it for nothing. You'll get to eat it.
On top of that.
You'll get it free. You'll get the shirt. You'll get your picture up there.
Now that and you get a free ride to the hospital, which you're probably going to die.
Now, if you can eat all of it, that's a pretty good deal because I imagine 5 pounds of seafood and sides is a pretty expensive dish.
No doubt.
Oh, yeah. I'm thinking somewhere around like the $49.99.
Yeah, I'm thinking somewhere around $50 or $60 if you don't eat it.
Yeah, right.
You don't get the shirt. You don't get your picture on the wall. And all your buddies are going to make fun of you, and you're still going
to
feel like crap.
And
so you might as well do it, right?
You still get the free ride to the hospital.
Yeah, you might as well get it done.
All right.
So the name, the Cod Father.
Yeah.
Right? We were...
it's a great name.
Yeah, so... We were down the Cape. My family was myself, my wife, and my 2 kids were down the Cape, and we were walking towards the beach. And my son saw on the side of a house there was a house down there called the Cod Father. So we're John and I are talking about this thing, and I mentioned it to my son Eric. He's 14, and I mentioned it to him, and he's like, "Dad," he says, "if you guys are going to do this thing, you got to call it the Cod Father."
Yeah, fantastic.
Right? So, you know, so
does he get a free shirt or does he have to eat it too?
He gets nothing.
He gets
to do the dishes after.
He likes swordfish sandwiches, so he'll get a free swordfish sandwich.
He's on the full scholarship anyway. You know what I mean?
I gotcha. So now you just cut up the scallops, you throw them right in the pan.
Yeah, we got the scallops going here. We had the oil going. I added a little bit of butter.
Okay.
Then you lightly brown the garlic, get that going. Then you pop in your shrimp and your scallops, get that sauteing. I'm going to add a little bit of fish stock, just a little, get that going. And you could also add a little bit of white wine if you wanted to.
Okay.
Or cooking wine. But if we had the white wine here, we'd probably be drinking it. So, you know, that wouldn't play out that way.
Joe, you mentioned about the fish stock.
Yeah. So the fish stock we make in the store, it's really a very, very strong condensed flavor, because what we do is we take about 15 pounds of haddock frames, and by frames I mean it's just the head and the torso of the haddock after it's been filleted.
Okay,
so it's just the bones. You take it, you put it in a large pot, you know, almost like a witch's brew pot, right?
Okay.
And you put fish, there's celery, black peppercorns, onion, the fish, and then you just let it cook. You let it cook down it takes about 7 hours, right? You let it cook down about 7 hours, and honestly, I mean, you could, if you heated that up and just ate it with the rest of that Iggy's bread, you'd be good, you know? You'd be good. It's delicious. It's a nice stock that we make, and, you know, we sell that at both stores as well.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So this is coming along nicely. The last thing we're going to do, once the shellfish is all cooked,
mm-hmm.
then we're going to add a little bit of the Ritz crackers. And we're going to add it to a point where it's not like a paste. You don't want it like that, because then it doesn't really give it much flavor. You just want to make it so it kind of binds all this together, and then all this stuffing is going to get stuffed into the lobsters.
Oh, I can't wait to see
that. So, if you want to...
So, Rick, we have a bowl here, which is basically what John put into the pan,
mm-hmm.
Right, so we make this, this is an herb butter.
Okay.
We make this and sell this in the store in Concord and Acton. You can, you know, you can pick this up if you don't want to go through the hassle of making all that stuff. All you have to do is take a nice spoonful of this, put it in the pan, and you're ready to go. You add the shellfish and you're good.
Is that
Shane,
good?
You get a good shot of this. This thing looks unbelievable.
We need that overhead. That's fantastic.
Yeah, you need the webcam.
So is that a good butter if you were just buying lobster to melt down and
dunk? Oh, absolutely. Oh. Yeah. So basically what's in here is this fresh parsley,
yep,
fresh garlic,
okay,
salt, pepper, and a good very rich butter.
Nice
rich
job,
butter,
Shana.
You know?
Yeah.
So, you know, we use this. We pre-make it. We do it like a shrimp scampi at the store with pasta, okay, and things, yeah, like that. So we pre-make this. It's nice and convenient.
Fantastic.
You know?
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
So we'll get these things done right here.
Yeah.
And so then I'm going to add the Ritz crackers to,
okay,
it, which adds a beautiful flavor to it. It's got a nice buttery, salty flavor.
That thickens it up too, I'm sure.
Yeah, and it's going to thicken it up. I'm going to lower the temperature on the stove, all right? Get that down just so it's simmering. Put the Ritz crackers in. Beautiful. We'll get that going. And then, Joey, why don't you...
It smells fantastic.
I know, it does. It's awesome.
I mean, it's unbelievable.
You can't smell it through the TV, but
no,
it is incredible.
No, so the first person...
That's what you need to work on.
The first person to invent that...
Yeah.
Smell-o-vision. Yeah. That's what we need.
Yeah. A first here at Acton TV.
Yeah, here we go, baby.
All right, so I'm gonna take the lobster. I'm gonna split them, and get them ready to be baked up.
What's the technique here to splitting a lobster? Because I imagine you can't just start whacking at it.
Right. So, when you make a baked stuff lobster, there's two different ways that you can do it. You can do it with the lobster being live.
Okay.
Right. And what you do is you take it live, have your fishmonger, you know, John, myself, whatever, anybody at the store. Split them down the middle, and you can take this stuffing, put it in there, and you can just bake them.
Okay.
All right, so you put them on a cookie sheet like this here, and a little bit of water, cover it with foil, and bake them from raw.
So, and what's the advantage or disadvantage to doing it that way as opposed to the way
The advantage of doing it already cooked, which is what we like to do.
Yeah.
These are actually parboiled. So what this does is, that's why we pre-cook all the ingredients in the stuffing.
Right.
And we can split this lobster, and then when the people pick them up, all they need to do is they need to take them home and eat them.
Oh, I gotcha.
Right,
yeah.
And heat them and eat them, right? So as opposed to maybe them, they're probably gonna have to cook, if you do them from raw, they're probably about 45 minutes.
Okay.
If you do them this way, we par cook them and just add the stuffing to them. They take maybe 20 minutes in the oven at home,
just
and boom,
they're
done.
Yep.
All right? So basically what you want to do is you want to find the area between the two claws. I don't know if you can get in here.
Yeah, we're right on it.
So, all right, so you want to find the area between the two claws and just cut down, right?
Now, is that a pretty soft part of the shell?
As long as you're in between the legs.
Okay. Yeah, you got a sharp knife, you can get through there.
Yeah, right? Okay.
So, and what you also want to do is if you cut the cartilage on the teal here before you cut through it, it'll make the teal nice and flat. It'll stay flat. Otherwise, it's going to continue to curl on you.
Okay.
Yeah,
right?
And then it's going to be tough to stop.
So you cut this all the way down. All the way down.
Oh, look at that.
Right? Just like that. You don't want to come through. You don't want to come through to the other side. Right? So that it kind of stays together.
Okay.
Then you just use your hands. Pull it apart. Flip it this way a little bit. Cut through the top. Now, there is one thing that I do want to show you here. Okay?
Yeah.
So in behind the eyes of a lobster. Okay? There's something which is actually the brain of the lobster. It's called the lady, right? If you boil them, you don't have to worry about it.
Okay.
Okay. But if you don't, if you do a baked stuffed lobster raw, or if you take a lobster and chop it up and saute it and do it kind of like Oriental style or Asian style, you do want to take this out, right? So right in here, right in the middle of the lobster, up in here behind the eye, there's a sac.
Oh, look at that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this sac here is called the lady.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, yeah, like I said.
And if you look at it, like if you wash that off and look at it,
yeah,
it looks like a lady.
No kidding.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, similar.
Yeah.
If you had 17 or 18 beers.
Exactly. Or a little, whatever. Anyways, so you want to get that out if you're going to eat the lobster from a raw stage, okay? If you boil it, you don't need to worry about
it. Now, what about the green inside? Now, I always thought that was the eggs that are in there.
No. So the green, which is called the tamale, is actually the, it's the liver, it's the organs inside the lobster, okay? It's delicious. My mother.
Oh yeah.
My mother, when she gets a lobster, she eats the red off the shell.
Now, that's
she
funny because I normally don't eat the green, and you're saying it's delicious. I've never even tried it.
It's tremendous.
Yeah.
Now, some people will ask us to take that out, but when we bake stuff a lobster, we leave that in there. We put the stuffing right in on top, and you get that nice flavor, you know, from the inside.
So if that's not the eggs, what do the eggs look like?
So we got a female here. So
that's a, is that the eggs in there?
Yeah.
Oh, there you are.
All right.
Okay.
So beautiful. What we have here. And I'll just take out a little bit. Hopefully you'll be able to see it.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Is that red, right?
Yeah.
It's kind of like a waxy consistency.
Okay.
So those are the actual eggs in a female lobster.
Oh, see that? You learned something new.
Yeah. So that's that.
High in protein, high in cholesterol, big time.
Right. Yeah. So now all you need to do is take off the elastics, right? Because we're gonna throw these in the oven for a bit. We want to open this up. You can put a little bit in there, John.
Yeah, stuff it up.
So you open up the upper cavity.
And you stuff this.
Put some nice stuffing in there.
Oh, that looks fantastic.
Open up the lower cavity a little bit.
I'll tell you, that makes me feel a lot better about them screaming when we threw them in.
That's a beautiful thing, huh?
I don't feel so bad.
So that's basically what a big stuffed lobster looks like right there.
Yeah. That's fantastic.
Going to hold that together. You got enough stuffing in there to hold it together, and it's, oh, look at that.
Look at that.
Are you kidding me?
That's beautiful.
That's a beautiful thing.
So do you want to do a break, and then do you want to keep stuffing them?
Well, I don't know. You can keep stuffing them.
Let's do the film,
I want to see you guys cut them up. It's fascinating.
So we have three more here. The guys running the cameras are drooling right now.
I'll tell you what.
They're out of their mind. They're completely out of control.
The guys at Twin Seafood are taking care of us tonight. I'll tell you that much. They said they were making baked stuff lobster. We thought one, maybe two. They show up with four lobsters.
Oh, yeah. This is beautiful. You guys are going to get to eat.
You guys are absolutely taking care of us.
I know.
Yeah.
I know.
That's what you say right now until you get the bill, you know. Right? So you see the tamale in there, right?
Yeah, it's quite
beautiful, right?
Yeah.
Now, like I said, you know, you could take the lady out if you choose, but you really don't need to if it's already boiled.
And we don't like to crack the claws, because if you bake stuff them and then put them in the oven with a cracked claw, the meat's going to dry out a little bit. So you might want to just keep it the way it is and let the people, when you bring it to the table and you plate it, let them crack the claws themselves, because it keeps it nice and moist and beautiful.
Now, how do you...
This is a perfect consistency. For the stuffing, by the way.
Yeah, it looks fantastic. I tell you, I could eat that just like that.
Yeah,
right there.
I was going to get it.
I'll wait, but you know what? I'm not going to wait.
No.
Eat it. It's delicious. It's tremendous.
Oh, that was fantastic.
Yeah, it's good.
Man, I can't.
It's going to be so much better with
it. And it's easy. I mean, really, what do we do, Rick? Really, you put some.
I could do that.
Yeah, put some olive oil, some butter. You brown your garlic. You throw your.
It's so good. I mean, you could eat it just like that. You really could.
It is. That's a meal. That's a meal right there. But with this.
Yeah, that's over the top.
Oh, you got me.
Unbelievable.
You know what people do with these? So Valentine's Day, you know, they'll buy two lobsters and have it, you know, get a couple bottles of wine, have a nice meal at home.
Yeah.
Christmas time, they'll do these for Christmas dinner, you know, and we'll do them for them. We'll bake stuff them, get them all ready.
So if you want to pick them up in the store, when you come to pick up a baked stuff, it looks just like that. It's all done.
Just like that, only we wrap it in aluminum foil.
Yep.
We give them to you. We tell you, okay, you're gonna pop them in the oven right before you eat, 15 minutes before you eat, 375 for 15 minutes. You're gonna heat them up, bang, you're gonna open up that aluminum foil, plate them, and bring them to the table, melt a little butter, and you're all set.
Is this the kind of thing where I should call ahead if I want that? Yeah,
because
you guys
want
to prep it up.
Give us probably like a half a day, so call in the morning, say you want to pick them up at 5 o'clock, perfect. You know, give us time to get it done.
Absolutely.
I mean, we could, you know, we could put them together within a couple of hours, but if you give us plenty of time, they'll be beautiful.
Right, yeah.
You know,
they'll
be perfect. And what we do is we charge the price of the lobster plus $10, you know, for this. You know, but that's a meal. I'm telling you, that's a meal right there. So it's a beautiful thing, and
it's crazy.
Yeah, we do it all the time.
All right, so we're going to stuff up that last lobster. We're going to take a break here. We'll be back, and we're going to plate up all this delicious food, and we'll sit down. And that's it. We'll be back right after this.
All right.
Can't wait to dig into this stuff, guys.
Absolutely.
Fantastic.
All right.
Welcome back to A Taste of Acton. We're sitting down with Joe and John LeBlondo of Twin Seafood. You guys have created an absolute feast for us here at the Acton Television Studios. Tell me, what's you guys' favorite thing on the table?
I would say my favorite would be the baked stuffed lobster.
The baked
and
stuff.
Honestly, not even the lobster itself, just the stuffing.
The stuffing.
That's
just the stuffing.
All I want to eat.
It's hard to disagree with that.
It's the best.
What do you think?
My favorite's the salad. As you can see.
So while you're behind the table, we can't tell.
Exactly.
That's
choice seating.
Yeah, you have a good seat.
You know what? Honestly, I love it all. I mean, yeah. I just love to eat, you know, yeah. which helps in cooking, you know. But like John said, the stuffing is fantastic. The crab cakes, I love the crab cakes. And, you know, I'm a sauce guy too, so this sauce here is fantastic. Yeah. I dip everything in it,
Before we dig in and try some of this fantastic food, we've already kind of sampled a little bit. You guys got to tell us, how can we get a hold of you guys? I mean, you got a website. Do you know the website address?
Yeah, the website is twinsseafood.com.
With an S.
So it's TWINS seafood.com. And it has everything up there. It's all informational. So it's not like you can do any like web purchasing or anything like that.
Okay.
But you can get information on what we have on our menu. You can get information about the clam bakes. You can get information on our hours, our telephone
catering
numbers.
You guys said that it was kind of a sit-down, kind of a takeout. Is one more of a sit-down than the other?
Yeah.
So if I wanted to go out to eat and have a nice seafood dinner.
Either store you can come in and you can sit
do
down and eat and, you know, have a nice dinner. There's no question about that. But Acton, in the nicer weather, we have a 900 square foot deck out there.
Right.
So you can sit down out there and eat at a picnic table. It's beautiful. Get a bucket of steamers. The nice thing about the store in Acton, too, is that you can bring your own beer.
Yeah.
Or wine, right? Or anything. I mean, you can bring, you know, Captain Morgan, if you like.
Okay.
Whatever you like.
All right.
And there's a place right down the street, Red, White, and Brew.
Okay.
You can go, walking distance, you can go down there, tell them you're eating that twin, and they'll set you up.
Yeah. Fantastic.
The guy,
no problem.
The owner's name there is Phil, right?
It's not the same deal in
Phil
Concord?
Phil Pagano.
No.
He's a nice Irish guy.
So Concord's a little bit different. Concord, you cannot, there's no carry-in license, so you can't bring in beer and wine. But you know, we have a full menu. We do a few pasta dishes in Concord. But you know, either store you can go in, and I can tell you this: in either store, you can take a look in the showcase. You can pick out a piece of fish. You can go into the lobster tank. You can grab your own lobster. We'll cook it for you.
That's awesome.
How much fresher can it get other than bringing something from the ocean? And you can do that too. Bring something to the ocean to us, and we'll cook that for you.
Is there ever a day of the week where you should call ahead for a reservation, or you can usually get a table?
We don't do any reservations.
First come, first serve.
Every now and then somebody will call and we'll try to put a table aside for them. But other than that, no, just come on
first
in.
First come, first serve.
And you know what? And grab a seat. When the weather's good, we have plenty of seating up in Acton.
Right.
You know, and there's plenty of seats down in Concord too. Yeah. So you can eat, and you're going to have tables outside.
We'll have outdoor seating down in Concord, not as much as Acton.
Okay.
But when the weather gets
better. But we have, you know, we have approximately 20 seats in Concord inside, and hopefully when the weather gets better, we'll have maybe another additional 10 or 12 outside. The only thing that you do need to do, and we talked about this earlier, was the only thing is if you want to rent the deck in Acton, right?
Right, the private
party. So you should call and reserve the space.
Yeah, and we do. You know who've been doing it a lot is the elementary schools. They do fundraisers.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah, so they'll do fundraisers, and what we do is we'll offer up the deck. You know, we don't charge them anything. For a fundraiser, we don't charge anything. And then we offer it just for $35 $30 a person.
That's
for the fundraisers. $30 a person, and they get the whole clam bake. They can bring in their own wine, and they can bring in their own beer.
It's a great deal.
And then they'll auction it off. They'll do these auctions at, like, Gates or some of the other schools in Acton, and they'll auction off for $75 a person, $100 a person, and that rest of the money after the 30 goes right into the school.
That's fantastic.
And we've done that, like Brian Carter in Acton has done it a couple of times, and he makes a ton. I think the last time he did it, he made $3,000 for Gates.
That's great.
Yeah, it was great.
All right, guys, I'm gonna dig in. I gotta try these crab cakes.
Yeah, you definitely gotta dig in on those.
Yep, you definitely gotta dip. You can see that.
Look at it. You know, those are 80% crab meat.
That's unbelievable.
It's all crab, man.
That's fantastic. Yeah. Yep. A little bit of pepper in there. I'm going to try that sauce. Oh, it just melts in your mouth.
Yeah. Delicioso?
That's fantastic.
Yeah,
guys.
Those are
come
good.
On.
Come
you
on.
Guys, you guys are out of control.
Come on.
Come on.
Yeah, it's a beautiful thing.
We are all out of time. I can't thank you guys enough. Yep. I had a great time. Thank you so much for coming down. If you need some good seafood in Acton, you got to check out Twin Seafood. Call ahead if you want the deck. And we'll see you next time on A Taste of Acton.
All right.